Y'all, I'm looking a hot mess. I feel a hot mess. I'm out here in Florida. This time I'm not on a vacation. I guess this is still a vacation because I'm out here with my other bae, my son. But you know how teenagers and kids are. They don't want to be fammed. And I mean, you can't do nothing but respect that. So yeah. You don't want to be filmed. Let's see. Palm trees in back of me? Yeah, I'm at my hotel. Just chilling. I'm waiting right now for my Uber Eats to come. And I'm ready to take this headband wig off, brush it out, put some conditioner in it, and put it to the side for tomorrow. I'm ready to put my bonnet on and chill for the night. Update on my breast and traveling. You see, I keep holding it. Just feel more secure when I hold it. So my breasts are a little sore still. I did have a little out of this breast. I am having some, I wouldn't call it an issue. But you know, we cool, we tell each other everything, right? We're besties. I gotta let you know what's going on with your bestie. This one is healing, looks like right perfect in my eyes. I'm not a doctor or a physician or a plastic surgeon, so I don't know. Y'all look behind me and tell me, y'all better tell me if it be some alligators or whatever, because it's a little swamp right there. You know, I am in Florida. And alligators and lizards and all that stuff do run around out here. So, all right, y'all. So, yeah. So, this breast, which is my right breast, this is the one that took almost 1,200 1,200 grams of breast tissue out of. They did test both of the tissues that they did take out of my breast. They both sides had benign tissue. And if you don't know what benign means, it means it's non-cancerous or any, you know, I don't have any infection, or it's just not, you know, it's a good thing. So my right breast is actually the areola is peeling, and you can see kind of the pink flesh underneath. I know that's kind of graphic for some of you, but for some of you it is not. And my videos are meant to be helpful, not distasteful, or gory, they're meant to be a tool or something else you can look at. And like I told y'all from the beginning, I'm keeping it all the way real with y'all, period, because I don't know any other way to be, and that's just my personality. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. Have I been in pain walking around? I wouldn't say I've been in pain, but I've been aching. And yesterday I took a Tylenol extra strength. One Tylenol extra strength and two ibuprofen 200 milligrams. And I was cool. So I just took that just in case, you know, something popped off and I didn't feel good when I was out there walking. Yesterday we went to Disney Springs. And my son brought his best friend with him. So he didn't have to be by himself with his mommy, because that gets to be boring. When you only have one kid and you want to take them on a vacation, it's kind of hard, because I mean, I'm glad his friend came. That's all I can say. I'm glad his friend came, because it's been a break for me. Even though my son's 16, but you know, he gets to have his friend with him. They've just been swimming and carrying on and just having them a good old time. And I've just been able to kind of chill, take it easy. They've been, for the most part, pushing open heavy doors for me, carrying my bags if I buy anything. If anything drops, him or his best friend will pick it up. Okay, what else? Hurricane. Is it Elsa or Elisa? Whatever. The hurricane was down here in Florida. Of course, the week I came. So it hasn't been super, super hot. Like, see my breast? It hurts right here. That's where I'm getting most of my pain from, right there. And I did have a little blood and pus, like I said, come out yet last night. No more than if you were to scrape your knee and then look at the Band-Aid, like a deep scrape, and then look at the Band-Aid, that kind of situation. But other than that, it was okay. I'm gonna make my post-op appointment is actually August the 2nd, and then that's for my breast, August 2nd. And then, as you guys know, I gotta have a hysterectomy because I have fibroids. So I'm gonna be having a hysterectomy, a full hysterectomy. However, they're going to leave my ovaries in. So hopefully it doesn't send me into premenopausal type, you know, deal or whatever. So that's that. I got all of that coming up, going on. And I know that I'm gonna be down bad after I have that surgery. I'm gonna be down bad. That surgery really scares me, because it's very painful, and I've heard a lot from several different women that had it, and they all said it was extremely painful and they were in a lot of pain, which scares me, because these doctors don't want to give you any type of pain medicine anymore, because all you pill heads, y'all done messed up the church's money. So now, when all of us, the rest of us, go to have surgery, they don't want to give us nothing. So we just about got to be at home rationing out pain pills and saving pain pills for a day that we're in more pain than we are that day, just because we're scared to be in pain. You damn pill heads. You damn pill fiends. I don't see how y'all do it. I don't see how y'all sit up here and pop all them pills. I just don't. It's not my thing. I don't see how you do it. Now, smoking some weed, yeah, I could see that. Doing cocaine, nope, couldn't see that. Heroin, nope, couldn't see that. Popping pills, I couldn't see that. But again, a lot of people say they ended up with these addictions after these surgeries and stuff. Or back in the day when these doctors used to just overprescribe. And now when we have something wrong with us, we just gotta send suffer. because they only want to give you 10 pain pills after a major surgery, and you're like, hold on now, you want me to take these every 4 hours? These gonna run out fast. So then you find yourself skipping stuff.